So now my goal is to start thinking about how we're going to warp an image to a different size. This is a global transformation or a global warping. And to help us, we will need to start looking at if we can come up with a set of parameters that on easy adjustment of these parameters, we can basically take a set of equations and generate a new output from a given input. So now we want to actually start looking at how to get an output image G if the f is given and we have a certain set of parameters to do this transformation. To help us, let's create just a simple coordinate axis here. Usually, if you remember, I always put the coordinate axis going down in y and x this way. Just for simplicity and consistency, I'm going to start using the traditional set of axes here. Of course, this would be the x-axis, the y-axis, and this would be the origin, right? Let's find another coordinate frame, and here, so assuming this is again the origin, and this is x and y, you notice this image has been moved a little bit. Let's claim that this has been translated by tx and ty, the translations in x and y. So this in essence kind of says that now I've translated the image. So this is basically warping or transformation of translation. Another similar example would be when I actually take the image, again the x and y axes that we've been paying attention to, origin, except that now you notice this image has been rotated. And if you draw this axis here, you might say that this has been rotated by amount theta. And that rotation actually now means that basically the same pixel values that I have here now appear in a different setup. And of course, thinking hard about it, you might also thinking this is basically changed the way rows and columns look and how my pixel values are looking. So this is basically looking at simple rotations. Let's look at a few additional examples of this kind of parametric warping or transformation of images. Again, my input image. In this one, I've stretched the image, right? In essence, what I've done is I've scaled it. I've added a basic additional dimension in the x-axis than I have here. Y in this one is, of course, the same. Resultant is, of course, my width is larger, and in this case, the height is the same. This basically where we just change one scale parameter is change of the aspect of the image. And of course, we could do this in both directions, x and y, and of course, that's the change in the scale of the image. Very simple stuff so far. Another example, where I basically have the same image, except this time around, if you notice, that we've actually done an interesting thing. What we've done here is we've added a little bit of perspective, a projective warp. Now, the top row is much, top numbers or top part is much smaller, bottom is larger, and in essence, the image seems to have flipped on that side a little bit. This is referred to as perspective, and this, of course, is an example where we have created an affine deformation of the image, where basically now the image seems to have a lot more shear. Again, different types of warps or transformation applied to the same pixel values, and of course, as you notice, the domain, the number of how the X and Y is changed depend on what kind of function we could apply. So let's now talk about what kinds of functions we could apply.